Business environment analysis is nothing just to scan various factors are responsible in order to analyze that what sort of things are there which are necessary while discussing, while studying or while scanning the environment. Let's talk about the various parameters of its analysis. In this process, first of all, we have to identify the environmental factors. Environmental factors includes like its internal, external, micro, macro, various parameters are there which has to be identified. Then we have to scan and select the relevant key factors. Now the time came that we have to decide and scan that what sort of parameters are essential for my studying purpose. Like for example, I have many parameters like micro, macro, I have internal, external, various parameters, but it may not be necessary that all sort of parameters are necessary in my relevant key factors discussing process. Then I would have to define variables for analysis. What sort of variables I'll be taking? I'll take regression, correlation, what sort of variables I'll be taking for analysis of my result. Then I'll be using different methods, techniques and tools. What more softwares, what more tools, SPSS. There are many methods and designs, tools and techniques are there which will be a helpful thing to analyze the actual results of our analysis process. Then I have to forecast the environmental factors. What sort of factors are relevant to me? I have to forecast that these are the relevant parameters in my business. Then I have to design the profiles. Designing profiles includes SWOT analysis and ETOP. SWOT analysis consists of strength, weakness, opportunities, and threat profiles, which will be in a kind of an help in your business in a current scenario for and as well as for the future purpose scenario. And ETOP is environmental threat and opportunity profile, which will also help you to design what sort of threats and what sort of opportunities are there in your environment. Then I have to frame out that what strategic position do I carry, and I have to prepare a detailed report of it so that I could keep it for my further purpose. These are the various factors and I hope you all understand it. Now let's talk about what is the significance of business environment. We all are talking about what is business environment, but why do we have to study it? We have thought about it, that what are the various parameters, but what is the need of it? First is first mover advantage. First mover advantage says that if you are the only first person who will take an initiative to move on that kind of a path, definitely you will get an advantage from the side of customers, because the first mover advantage is a thing that if you are the first person who will moving in that direction, customers will influenced by you, customer will convinced by you. Then is customer focus. Customer focus says that you have to focus on customer. You have to think that customer is the king of the market. The goods which are tailor-made goods, the goods which are as per the needs of customers are only in the market scenario as per the need. Then change agent. You have to become a change agent. Change is a kind of a mantra of each and every business. If you are not opting for different changes, definitely gradually and so slowly you will be out of the market. For that, you have to adopt various change as per the time passage. Continuous learning, definitely it is not a work of a day or two. It requires a regular learning. Learning in the sense you have to change regularly. You have to realize, you have to analyze various factors on the regular basis. Then early warning signal. You have to frame out if there is any kind of a threat. You should take it out on the early basis so that it can be rectified and correct on the prior notice. Public image. You should also think about that what sort of public image do you carry. For example, if that public image is better one, it will help you to build your goodwill. It will help you to sustain in the market. It will help you to get more customers. But if your public image is not that much good, then it will not help you to get more customers, to get more clientele. Then image building. Image building is what sort of goodwill you are creating in the market. If your goodwill is better, your market value is better. You would be able to create much more customers. And if it is not that kind of an image, you would be dealing with not that much level of customers in the market. Now let's talk about what are the further challenges of business environment. First is economic and market conditions. Market is dynamic. Economic is dynamic. Things are changing very frequently. You have to think about it. then customers need and demand, what sort of need and demand customer possess, what they are thinking, what they want, because customer is the king of the market. We have to make tailor-made or the custom-made products. Then competitors, what sort of practices, policies, things they are publishing, they are possessing, we have to think it. And we have to frame ours also. Then new opportunities and threat. As I have said earlier, market is dynamic. Every time new threats, new opportunities are coming and gearing up in nowadays. We have to look towards it. We have to look forward toward it so that we can change in our business scenario.